Hello everyone, do you like this guy's voice? I think his voice is really funny, so I decided to use it for this video. His voice is especially funny when he says cuss words. Listen to how fucking funny this is, bitch, I am dying. Or how about this? I never fucked Wayne, I never fucked Drake all my life, man, fuck's sake, if I did I menage with M and let M eat my ass like a cupcake. Here's to never getting monetized. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this, even though this slightly terrifying robotic man is speaking to you. I just think his voice is so fucking funny. Okay, anyways, let's get into the video. So you want to know more about the best band ever, Queen? Excellent. Let's start from the beginning. Before Queen, there was a band called Smile. Smile consisted of Brian May, Tim Staffel, and Roger Taylor. In my opinion, the band was pretty lit. However, the band Smile was short-lived, and before the band knew it, they were broken apart by an Imperial Art College student. As you probably guessed, that student was Freddie Mercury, or at the time, Freddie Bulsara. That's right. Freddie was not only an amazing singer, songwriter, musician, and performer, the bitch was artistic as fuck as well. Eventually, Tim Staffel decided to leave the group due to artistic differences, and Freddie became the new frontman. And no tea, no shade, Tim Staffel, but thank God Freddie became the new frontman of Smile. Let's continue. Since Freddie is a fucking fierce diva queen, he renamed the band Queen. Even though Brian and Roger hated the name and wanted to kill him. Of course, not long after Queen became Queen, bass player John Deacon was found. And don't you forget it. As most of us know, after Queen was formed they produced a fuck ton of amazing popular music, and they are still relevant today. Now, I have been a fan of Queen for about 4 years now, so of course, I am thoroughly up each member's asshole. Because of this, I will give you a thorough description of each member in Queen. Let's start with the most underrated member, John Richard Deacon. And yes, I know their full names. I wasn't lying when I said I was up each of their assholes. To start, John Richard Deacon was born on the 19th of August 1951. And he made sure you knew that, especially in this interview.
I'm Freddie Mercury and I'm the lead vocalist for Queen.
I'm Brian May and I play guitar for a group called Queen.
Roger Taylor and I'm the drummer and one of the singers of Queen.
My name is John Richard Deacon. I was born on August the 19th, 1951.
I'm sorry, but please explain to me why every other member explained what they did in Queen. Meanwhile, John told his entire life story. If you didn't know, John Deacon was the best dancer in Queen. End of discussion. Many people in the fandom call him Disco Deaky for that reason. Here is proof that John is the grooviest dad you will ever see. Bitch, did you see that spin? And check out his booty shorts. Honestly, Beyonce is quaking. Another thing you need to know about John is that his favorite food is apparently cheese on toast. No wonder he is so fucking skinny. If you could not already tell, John is the smallest bean in Queen. And if you don't think he is adorable, I will have to fight you. Not only is he adorable, but he came up with the songs Another One Bites the Dust, Under Pressure, and many more. And no, he didn't sing on really any Queen tracks. But we don't talk about that. Lastly, John is the sassiest member of Queen. And that is no lie. Many people think that Freddie is the sassiest member, but in my opinion, John is the baddest bitch in Queen. Just saying. I mean, look at his hair. He is serving a look. And his hair is higher than my GPA ever was in high school. Oh, and one more thing. John has a lot of fucking kids. And guess what? His son Luke looks just like him and I kind of want to slide into his DMs, but it is fine. And also, he married a woman named Veronica in the 70s, and they are still married today. Holy fucking shit, that is so cute and sweet, I cannot. Overall, John seems like the shyest and quietest member in Queen, but in reality, he is the flyest gangster in Queen. Next on the list is Roger Meadows Taylor. How fucking majestic does that sound? Almost everyone in the fandom is a slut for Roger, and most of us agree that Roger is prettier than us. In fact, many people believe that Roger could possibly be a woman, especially when he appeared as Rogerina in the I Want to Break Free video. Speaking of Rogerina, she is 100% cuter than me and could easily steal my man if I had one. Moving on, Roger Taylor's falsetto is fucking ridiculous, and if you don't believe me, just listen to this. I just creamed my pants. Continuing with Roger's high notes, please know that the high note in Bohemian Rhapsody is Roger as well, and not Freddie Mercury. Also, in Somebody to Love, there is a part that sounds like Brian's guitar is wailing, but in reality, it is Roger Taylor's orgasmic falsetto instead. Bitch, I am fucking shook. Something important you need to know about Roger Taylor is that he really loves cars, so much in fact that he wrote a fucking song about them. The song is called I'm in Love with My Car, and Roger wanted it on the B-side of Bohemian Rhapsody, but Freddie did not approve. Because of this, Roger decided to lock himself in a cupboard, and would not come out until Freddie approved. Needless to say, Roger got his way, and Freddie approved. I swear, this band is so fucking extra I cannot. Another thing you need to know about Roger: Drunk Roger is the best Roger. Here is an example.
I'm not sure, I've just written this new one, which I'm really excited about.
Can you tell he's really excited about it? Another thing about Roger: he really likes to put his hands in his shirts. And I have no idea why that is. Maybe he's into nipple play. Aside from I'm in Love with My Car, Roger has some solo songs as well, such as Man on Fire. The songs are pretty lit. However, Roger's acting is something awful. Here is an example. Someone explain to me why he looks like an angry gerbil. And also, why did he start playing leapfrog by himself? Overall, Roger is a great drummer, model, drunkard, and car enthusiast. Oh, and did I mention his voice is higher than mine? And yes, Roger has children as well. His son Rufus is pretty spicy, if I do say so myself. Next we have Brian Harold May. And let me tell you, this bitch literally does everything. As if being a rockster isn't fucking enough, he has a PhD in astrophysics. Brian also heavily supports animal rights, and he is a savage when it comes to calling people out on Twitter. Oh, and did I mention he fucking loves badgers? No, seriously, I'm surprised he hasn't proposed to a badger yet. Aside from playing a fuck ton of instruments, Brian helped with backup vocals, and oftentimes Brian would write some super depressing emo as fuck music for Queen. For example, he wrote a song called All Dead All Dead, and it is super upsetting, but also a fucking bop. The most important thing to know about Brian May is that he is a fucking meme. Yes, a meme. Here are some examples. What a fucking meme. Also, fun fact, Brian May totally looks like Isaac Newton. Did I mention, this man has a fucking selfie stick. Brian and his wife Anita are the cutest couple to ever exist. And if you don't believe me, here is the proof. Wow, I have never felt more lonely. And yes, the rumors are true. Brian did have an affair with Anita while still being with his first wife, Christine. But guess what? We don't talk about that. Oh, somehow I almost forgot to mention, this man would be a clogfoot model if he could. No, seriously, he fucking loves clogs. And yes, we know his hair makes him look like a poodle, but he is a cute poodle. And one more thing, bearded Brian makes me moist, even though he kind of looks like Jesus. And that makes me slightly uncomfortable. Overall, Brian May is essentially a genius, a good person, and most importantly, of course, the meme king. Lastly, we have Freddie Mercury. As most of you know, Freddie is my favorite member of Queen. So get ready to hear his entire fucking life story. Freddie's actual name is Farrokh Bulsara, and he is originally from Zanzibar, not the UK. Also, Freddie was the cutest baby to ever exist. Do not fight me on this. To put Freddie simply, his voice is untouchable.
Somebody love.
Your fave could never. His stage presence is not of this world. And his smile makes me want to backflip into fucking oblivion. Speaking of Freddy's smile, if you want to talk smack about his teeth, then I suggest you leave, or else, you will have to catch me outside. How about that? And don't even get me started on his laughter.
Did you hear that? Pom chum fish. Oh, it's too much. There was three of us in the... We all came in a bit late. I know, I shouted one and came in myself late.
Holy fucking shit, that hurt me. Believe it or not, Freddy is the only member in Queen who liked men. That is, unless you read Queen/fanfiction. But that's for another video. Some people in the fandom argue that Freddy was strictly gay, and others say he was bisexual. But if you like me, you just don't give a shit. Freddy is daddy, that is all. Speaking of Freddy's sexuality, Freddy had a variety of partners, one in particular who is a total shithead. His name is Paul Prenter. We don't know him. Two of Freddy's most talked about partners are Mary Austin and Jim Hutton. Barbara Valentin is another one. But guess what? We don't know her. Anyways, Freddy kept his personal life pretty private. So let's continue. Another thing. Freddy is a fucking amazing piano player. Seriously, check this shit out. If I tried to do that, my fucking hand would fly off. Freddy is also a good guitar player, even though he says he only knew three chords. Sorry Freddy, but that's fucking bullshit and we know it. Stop being so fucking humble. It is a proven scientific fact that Freddy's cheekbones could easily cut a bitch. Also, Freddy's chest hair is like beautiful taco meat. Also Freddy's muscles. Fuck my asshole please. Also, Freddy's nose is absolutely perfect. Damn. I really am obsessed with this bitch. Also, I have nothing to say about that. Also, Freddy's lips, that is all. As we know, Freddy did not have any children of his own. Unfortunately, he died in 1991 due to pneumonia caused by AIDS. But guess what? We don't talk about it. I forgot to mention, Freddy has a sister named Kashmira. And yes, she does have a son. And no, he doesn't look much like Freddy. Also, I love Freddy's mum Jer so much. She is an angel and a fierce diva queen. Unfortunately, she passed a while back, but I am glad she is reunited with Freddy now. Fuck, I am getting emo. I better move on. One more thing. Freddy said he was a terrible songwriter and once again, that bitch was lying. Every song he ever wrote is amazing and I know it. Overall, Freddy is a cute shy bean that somehow controls thousands of people. His voice is unreal. He is a legend, and he is the sexiest motherfucker I have ever seen. To best summarize Queen, they are four sassy dads who just so happen to be rockstar legends. And did I mention, these four idiots had Scrabble competitions while touring. I fucking cannot with this band. Well, I guess this is it. If you like this type of video, please let me know. And yes, I will make one for Michael. Thank you for watching. I love you all. I would try to do the snap and the peace sign. But as you can see, I am a robot. Anyways, toodaloo.